his stick. Doughty with the effort there. Heinen races to get to it, and it's kept in by Phil Deneau. He connects. Arvidsson shooting. Pat stop from Skinner. Big rebound. Anderson to Doughty. Anderson tees one up and scores. And the Los Angeles Kings have life.
Makes a nice poke check out of the defensive zone, and he gets his feet moving, and it's a little bit too hard of a ring by Zach Hyman. So possession is kept. The first blast by Arvidsson is stopped. The second one by Anderson has some eyes. Gets his head up. It's not as hard as the
5 minutes and 48 seconds a game this regular season.
He's a minute muncher.
It's Kempe out front, and the Kings score. All of a sudden, this time for real, the deficit is indeed cut in half.
Behind the net, walks out, says, yeah, why not? And throws it through. He's actually looking for a tip. It might be Byfield that gets a piece of this. I thought it was Kempe. Maybe it goes off a skate here. But it's Byfield. Byfield gets that paddle down. That's a beautiful pass from Kempe. And Quinton Byfield, who had a breakout year this season.
Here comes Kempe. Leaving it in the hands of Dubois, maneuvering his way in, and that puck bounces into the net off an Oilers skate. A fortuitous bounce for the Los Angeles Kings, who are within three with 3:04 left in the third.
And it's Dubois from a pretty sharp angle. He likes to try and shoot this one off the stick of CC, off the body or skate of Darnell Nurse. You're going to see it right there off the skate and find its way in the net. So a double deflection. Stick, CC, skate, Nurse, and he says, sorry about that, partner. Typical playoff goals around the net.
CC, whose stick broke LaVerie to Moore, and they score. And all of a sudden, the Los Angeles Kings are within two with a minute and 11 to go in the third period. My, oh my.
Yeah. And as we talked about, between these two teams, they don't go away. They always continue to claw back, always continue to try and do something. This stick just evaporates in CC's hands, and LaFerriere with a nice pass over to Moore, and he taps it home. Not much you can do. CC tries to play it with the hand, but he puts it right to LaFerriere, who will get his.
His stick waits. A pass up. Mikey Anderson moving in with Byfield. And the Kings lose the puck as Bouchard advances, but Kopitar keeps it in. Kempe, a quick shot and a quick goal. First on the score sheet is Adrian Kempe. And the Kings have a early 1-0 lead.
Jack breaks up the play, and then it's in possession. And this little soft play off the wall, it looks like it's up the wall to Fogel, but a great pick off and read by Kopitar. The quick pass in the middle, and that laser fast shot by Kempe. He is an Edmonton killer. He has had fantastic playoff series against them. Leads all players now with 17 points in the last 3 years facing Edmonton in the postseason. He gets his team on the
back into the middle. The shot, that stop from Talbot. And now on the counter attack, a 3-on-2 developing for the Kings. Kopitar centering pass. It's in the net. And all of a sudden, the Los Angeles Kings have a 2-0 lead with just over 5 minutes to go in the first period. And it's Adrian Kempe once again.
And you've had to grind for your chances. This is just a little play by Kopitar. Throws it into an area, goes off a one stick, and then the hand eye right there by Kempe to knock it out of the air. I mean, he's driving to the net. Kopitar knows it, throws it in there, hoping it gets through. And it does get slowed down a bit, and the baseball swing out of the air. A little tap by Kempe, his second of the game. I mean, he...
Here's Arvidsson now to Doughty. A breakaway. Doughty's in. And the puck. Where is it? The Kings are celebrating. They score. What a way to answer back. And LA regains a 2-goal lead.
On this play out of the zone, he's going to get to this puck first on Big Day Harnay, then he just throws it into an area, and it's Drew Doughty that's there first. Now he gets a little bit of a break as he can't handle this puck. He's getting a little bit of a hook from behind, but this puck finds its way through Stuart Skinner and into the net for a 3-1 lead. Right after Edmonton scores, it's Drew Doughty with his first playoff goal in a while, gives his team the 2-goal lead once again.
He's made a habit of it with those sharp angle shots right near the goal. Fiala catches up to it. Ekholm. And all of a sudden, Byfield, who moves in. Byfield powering his way to the net. It was wide. Good defensive effort by Darnay to stay with him. One-timer shot, and it's in the the net, the Kings score all of a sudden and regain the lead.
What a shot by Fiala. I mean, this is a rocket. And we talked about his release on the wrister. This is a one-timer. It looked like a harmless play. Good drive into the zone by Byfield, who's had another strong game, jumping up and down lines. And then a little pass to the point, and Fiala is ready for this one. He just gives it back to the blue line, little pass back by Spence, and bang. It's off the stick, little screen in front. It finds its way through, and the Los Angeles Kings take the lead once again.
Mikey Anderson. Anderson now has the puck. Here's Kopitar with an opportunity, and he scores! The Kings captain, Anze Kopitar, the overtime hero for LA, and the Kings steal game two, 5-4, final score.
And then a beautiful pass up the ice, right on the tape. And a little redirection to Kopitar, who walks in. They did take a look at this for a long time to see if he was onside. He had to delay as this one comes off the wall into the middle, and then he picks his spot up over top of the glove of Stuart Skinner. The Los Angeles Kings were never behind in this game. They had the lead 2-0, 3-1.
Down the big tower, Vincent Desharnais. And a big battle in front of the net now between Kulak and Kopitar. Byfield, back, and he scores!
You need something to happen. We haven't seen one scrum in this game so far. The Kings are down 3-0. They come out hungrier, more aggressive, and you knew after a tough first period for Drew Doughty. Turnover led to the 1-0 goal. Penalty led to the 3-0 goal. The greatest players in the game respond, and this is a response by Doughty. Gets down on the doorstep, the battle in front, Kopitar.
By Draisaitl, and there you have it. The Edmonton Oilers with a 1-0 victory in game four. And they push the LA Kings to the brink of elimination. Kulak cleared just over half a minute to go as Gavrikov. He rips it in and took a funny bounce. Here's a chance, and the Kings score! My, oh my. You cannot script this stuff. All of a sudden, with 28 seconds to go in the first period, it's Laferriere.
Continue to try and get on the forecheck. This one here catches a stanchion. You can see Stuart Skinner's out to play this one. Knock it down, goes off the stanchion. And you can see the dive back into the middle trying to stop this one from going in the net. It's big Vinny Desharnais, but it goes off of his stick and up over top of the paddle of Stuart Skinner. Just a ring around, and Laferriere just gets there first.
It's England. All the way up ahead. Arvidsson into Lizotte, and he scores! Blake Lizotte, his first of the playoffs, and that's the go-ahead goal for the Los Angeles Kings.
Great quick up here. Here to look up the ice and say, hey, Englund just says, I see a body up on the ice. It's Arvidsson who puts it into an area, and Lizotte skates into this puck with speed, and he has the shot on his mind right from the point that he picks up this puck, picks that spot above the right pad, under the blocker, and he buries it for a 2-1 lead. Beautiful little area pass in the backhand side.
Nugent Hopkins defending.
Riddick's on the bench.
He is, and now the extra attacker, Matt Roy. A pass tip, and they score! Can you believe it? The no-quit Los Angeles Kings are within one. And it's Adrian Kempe once again.
And you can see these guys are exhausted coming back to the Los Angeles bench. Boy, I'll tell you, they have been working. They've been throwing pucks. Great redirection. On this shot from the blue line, it's Roy gets his head up, the wrister with eyes, and right there, the redirection by Adrian Kempe finds the back of the net. Now a one-goal game with 2:18 on the clock. Brent's going to head back.